Hello guys, welcome back to my channel and AGMR and Movie Reactor. So today we're gonna be watching a video on Captain Marvel's powers and abilities. I'm gonna explain it to you guys, and also we'll be watching Carol Danvers' abilities before she had turned up into Captain Marvel. So before we get to know all these things, I'll just briefly explain you about Carol Danvers, how she had turned up into Captain Marvel in this video. So without any further ado guys, let's just start our video. So guys, Carol Danvers was an a normal human being like us before, and her main intention was to become a pilot, and finally she worked hard for it, and she did succeed in becoming a pilot. And she had a job offered from NASA saying that she had to go to space and discover something in another planet. So even she had accepted it, and she had traveled to space with her team, and she had traveled to a different planet known as the Kree Empire. So in this planet, there was a fight going on between the Kree Empire aliens and the Captain Marvel, not the Miss Captain Marvel, but the original one, the male version. So those two armies are fighting out there in that planet. And Carol Danvers was stuck in between them, and she couldn't do anything. So at that moment of fight, a Captain Marvel's weapon known as Magnetron just attacked by mistake on Carol Danvers, and she was affected by that Magnetron's beam. And later on, she came back to Earth, and she was normal, but she didn't know what that Magnetron beam had on her. She had a lot of changes in her DNAs later on, but she was not aware of it. So for a while it had been continuing in her body, and she didn't notice it. And at one point she came to know about her special abilities that she has gained due to that that attack that was made on her by mistake by this Magnetron. And finally she comes to know, and she faces many problems, and she ends up becoming Captain Marvel. So this was the origin about Carol Danvers, that is a Captain Marvel, guys. So now I'm just gonna explain you and tell you the powers that Captain Marvel has, and also the abilities that Captain Marvel has got in her. So the first power that we are gonna see in Captain Marvel is super flight. So in this power, it just enhances her to move fast. She can just run as fast as Quicksilver, as we have seen, or even the Flash. And she can also travel in the speed of a missile that travels, and she can fly in the speed of a missile. And that's what this super flight ability gives her. So the second one that we are gonna see is enhanced strength. So enhanced strength means you would have watched a lot of DC movies, then you would have known that Superman has got a lot of strength, as even he is having this kind of power, which is known as the enhanced strength. And in this movie, even Captain Marvel will be having a similar power of Superman, that is enhanced strength. She'll be having a lot of strength to lift any kind of object, and she can throw any object no matter what weight it is. So that's what this enhanced strength is about. So the third one in our list comes the super durability. So you might ask me, what is super durability help her in what kind of ways? So for an example, Thanos has collected all the 6 Infinity Stones in his gauntlet, and when you would have watched the Infinity War climax scene, the Thanos will use his gauntlet towards Thor, and this, all the 6 Infinity Stones will just emit a beam together, and the similar kind of beam, if it is emitted towards Captain Marvel, she can just absorb all that energy possessed from the beam into her body, and she can just store that beam in her body and use it against her enemies as an weapon. So this is a very rare and special ability that Captain Marvel has got in her. And this ability you would have seen similar to this ability in Black Panther's suit, and it's almost same kind, but she stores it in her body, not in her suit. So that's the difference between them. So the fourth one that we're gonna see is the photonic blast. So this energy, it just emits out from both of her hands. It's almost like a solar beam emitting out of her hand, and she can aim on her enemies, and it's almost like in the because, you know, Captain Marvel has more power compared to Superman. So this photonic blast will be more effective than Superman's beam. So this one has, you know, more strength compared to him. So the fifth one on our list is the superhuman stamina, guys. So this ability gives her, you know, a lot of stamina that she wants during the fight or the battle. As you all know that the Captain America, you know, even he has a lot of stamina and has a never give up attitude. But at some circumstances, even he has to, you know, give up and even he falls down. But, you know, Captain Marvel has such ability that she'll never even fall down in any sort of situation. So that's this superhuman stamina. And the sixth one on our list is the superhuman reflexes. So this ability was gained by her when the magnetron's beam, you know, just influenced in her body. And all those DNA changes occurred in her body. You know, from that time, you know, her age will never, you know, increase. Because of this ability, she'll stay in the same age, all her face, complexions, and nothing will be changed. So that, you know, the same amount of strength and the same amount of stamina will be in her. And this all is because of this superhuman reflexes. So the last one that we're gonna see in our channel is the healing factor, guys. So this healing factor gives an ability to her by which, you know, if she's injured or, for example, if she has some cuts on her arms or something, this healing factor helps her, you know, to heal in a very rapid and quick rate, by which, you know, in a fraction of seconds, those cuts will just vanish off. So you would have seen these abilities similar to, you know, Deadpool. So it's almost similar to Deadpool's ability, and this one is much more faster and much more effective. So guys, those are the seven most, you know, powerful powers in Captain Marvel that I could gather and tell you. So quickly, you know, let's just see what are the skills that, you know, Carl Danvers had, you know, before turning into Captain Marvel. What were the abilities that she had? I just have some three listed out, so let's be quick and finish them. So the first thing is she's a skilled pilot. So this was, you know, I just told you guys in the beginning itself that her aim was to become a pilot, and she was working for NASA as a pilot also. So she's very skilled in this stuff, and she knows, you know, to handle any kind of and flight or in jet. So she's very, you know, skillful in this thing. So the second one is she can go hand to hand combat with anyone. So it's like, you know, she doesn't require any kind of equipment or weapons. She can just go hand to hand with someone, you know, even more powerful than her. And she has all the guts to face anyone that she wants, because, you know, she's kind of trained with martial arts or something. So she can, you know, fight with anyone, and she can even get a win over them. And the last one is multilingual. So this multilingual means that, you know, she's mastered almost all the important languages in the world. And, you know, so that she'll not be having any problem in communicating in any of the most popular languages in the world. Wherever she can travel, she can just communicate in that language. So these ways. So that's it from my channel today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So all these information, you know, I just gathered it from the comic book. So I can assure you that all these abilities and powers will be added in the MCU universe, that is the cinematic universe. So I hopefully that, you know, think that most of these powers will be similar in the movies too. So the pilot thing will be in the movie as far as I know. And the remaining abilities, you know, I can assure you that it will be in the movie, guys. So that's it from my channel today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you really like the video, you can click the like button below. And if you want any more videos of any topics that you want me to make a video on, you can just comment it in the comment section below. And I'll be making the video for you within 24 hours. And for those who haven't subscribed my channel yet, please do click the subscribe button by clicking it below. And also click the bell icon next to that, so that you don't miss out a single update from my channel, and keep enjoying all the videos that I upload on my channel. So let's meet again in another interesting video from my channel, guys. So until then, signing off from